Weapons fire detected.
This drawing is the only thing that Da Vinci left behind for us. So any research of this battle machine comes out from this picture anyway. Therefore, I decided not to look for any information initially, and remain unaffected until I form my own opinion. A little bit of history. The giant crossbow drawing is a part of Codex Atlanticus and is one of many inventions that Da Vinci never built up. The historians believe that the goal was to gain the favor of Ludovico Sforza, and as with Da Vinci's tank, nobody really expected the weapon would be ever built. Based on the figure on the original Da Vinci picture, I believe that dimensions are approximately 24.5 meters, length of the limb and 22 meters, length of the body. Blender showed me that the volume of the wooden parts is 38 cubic meters and 1.6 cubic meters of the iron parts. Therefore, we can suppose that the weight of the wooden parts is almost 20 tons, and the weight of the iron parts is 13 tons. The real size can be best realized while walking around it. You can do so on our website Battle Machines. Let's take a closer look at each section. Limb is the most important part of the crossbow. While I was working on the 3D model, I realized that this could not work on such a scale. Wood is not a rubber. You can bend it, but you cannot squeeze it. Then I noticed that the inner side is made up of several smaller parts, probably separated from each other by gaps. Everything started to make sense. This is to prevent the string holder from sliding and at the same time to use the advantage of the flexibility of the rope. The cocking mechanism is simple. The problem is that such a wooden coil would have had the high friction even if it had been made very precisely and had been sufficiently lubricated. The charging would have taken 10 minutes and would have been tedious for the operator, which does not make this battle machine very efficient. Da Vinci suggested two ways to release the string. Either with a hammer blow, or with a lever. Notice the inclination of the wheels in the original picture. Such talented artist and skilled inventor like Da Vinci certainly did not draw it like this only as a coincidence together with a very weird construction. It will definitely be a way to change the angle of the shot. In my opinion, Da Vinci relied on wheel spikes to help keep the wheels at the right angle. Such a chassis would not have worked according to Da Vinci's ideas in the real world. A much more complex mechanism should have been produced, perhaps similar to today's car axles. I remember a document, in which a group of experts made a prototype. They fired to the distance of 4 to 5 meters. So would this military machine work? No. Does it look great? Yes, and that is important for us. Isn't it? You can have a closer look and explore the 3D model on the website Battle Machines, where you can also find many things to download. A lot of work is needed to create these animations. For that I'm simply not able to upload new videos too often. But I'm sure you already know what to do to not forget this channel and get a notification about the next upload. No worries, I'm definitely not going to fill up your notification area. Thanks for any support and feel free to visit my website battlemachines.tech.